are yet to give the first speech of Pathways? Raise your hand. Okay, there are a few people. Alright. So, Pathways, when it rolled down in our district in the month of May this year, there was a lot of confusion. The first thing that we who have been there with older program of Toastmasters, we used to get two booklets when we just joined Toastmasters. One was called Competent Communicator Manual. Another one was Competent Leader Manual, Leadership Manual. So the idea was that there were several projects, 10 projects in each one of them. You have to do them, that means you have to prepare your speech accordingly and then give that speech and get it evaluated so that you are learning step by step. The same program had a parallel where you had Competent Leadership Manual. In Competent Leadership, you were given tasks like Toastmaster Alfred just mentioned, Toastmaster of the Day is one of the tasks where you take any kind of leadership roles. And every single role that we have in Toastmaster Club gives you some kind of element, some kind of teaching about leadership or your own inner personality development. Even communication is a part of leadership. I hope you all agree, right? Now, this program rolled in, and Toastmasters International announced that in next 2 years, the traditional program will be shut down and everyone has to adapt to this one. The people who were very new to the club, like me, were very confused about what we have to do. Toastmaster Pathways is there. We have traditional program, but we are not sure whether we'll be able to finish that in 2 years or not. So I took a chance, okay, decided that I will go with the Pathways. And so far, my experience has been wonderful, and that is what I am going to tell you about in the next few minutes. I'll also tell you what new components as a part of whole Toastmaster journey have been added as Pathways program. I shall move to the next slide. So, Pathways, as the name says, offers you 10 different learning paths. Dynamic leadership, coaching, on-team collaboration. My path is persuasive influence, because it offers something which my regular day job will not give me too much power to learn. So I decided my path accordingly, but Toastmasters website, when you log into it, you go to the Basecamp, it will ask you a couple of questions, and based on the answers that you give, they will recommend a couple of these paths which you can take. You have to pick one of them. And let us go further and see what this is like. So once you pick a path, there will be 5 levels within that path. Each level has several new kind of challenges. They are getting more and more advanced. Right now, most of us in Hyderabad or in all of District 98, that is 5 South Indian states, most of us are in level 1 or we have just started level 2. I am at almost the end of level 1. And now let me talk about my journey. The first project that you have to do is very much similar to regular Competent Communicator CC manual project 1, which is icebreaker speech. So you have a 4 to 6 minute of speech, very simple speech. All you have to do is come up to the stage. And even it is allowed if you have notes on your hands, no problem, you can read, but it is recommended that you actually communicate rather than just reading out aloud. So all you have to do, spend some time with your mentor and you plan what you want to speak, what you want to talk about. People have very different ideas about how to express themselves. Some people take it chronologically, where they were born and they grew up and then they went to college, then they started working, what they are doing right now, and how Pathways or Toastmaster journey is connected with their short-term and long-term goals. Meanwhile, some people look at it totally differently. Like, I have seen speeches where a person introduces personal aspects, professional aspects, and then in the middle, there is Pathways. 3 P's, even sounds innovating. So the first speech is very simple. You get it evaluated, and the evaluators, especially at this level, are very much supportive. The goal is not to go up and speak, and if anything goes wrong, you might be bashed by the public. Not at all. The only purpose is to stand so that you introduce yourself to the club. That's it. And if your evaluator and your mentor believe that there are some aspects that you are already good at, and there are some things, some very small aspects that you still need some improvement on, they will guide you further accordingly. That's the aim of this particular project. Next project contains 3 components, where you have to give 2 speeches and 1 evaluation. This is a little different to those who are coming from traditional education program. Normally we have Competent Communicator Manual, according to which you have to give some speeches. And then you have leadership manual, where one aspect is that you have to evaluate a speech. In this part, they have combined both these aspects together. So what you have to do, once you are done with project one, you move further to project two. And one of the most important aspects of Toastmasters Club is to provide you a very supportive environment where you learn, you grow, and you improve on your communication skills. In second project, the first task is for you to prepare a 5 to 7 minute speech on any topic. The topic can be about the books you are reading right now, the sport leagues you are following right now, current affairs, your personal ambitions, or maybe any other topic. There is no restriction as such, apart from those three controversial topics which Sergeant at Arms informs you about. You can talk about anything. Here again, the aim is not to give a very glamorous speech or to make the audience impressed. The goal is to learn how to accept feedback. Once you are done giving a speech, your evaluator will come and they will share their 2 to 3 minute feedback and tell you what were the points where you were good in and what are the points for which you need improvement. And another very interesting aspect for me personally in the second project is the second part of it. You get the evaluation. You have a written copy where evaluator has written their points, especially mentioning what are the factors where you need improvement. And then it is recommended that you give the same speech again and probably, if possible, get it evaluated by the same person. Although there is no hard and fast rule, but where it helps is when you give the same speech again, there will be a lot of things where you will find that last time you did something differently and this time you can totally put it upside down and create some magic in your speech. I hope till this point everyone is clear what the path looks like. The third part is where you take one step further. You have already taken some evaluation, you have received feedback, and you know how feedback actually helps. This is the time where you have to do the hard job, evaluating someone else. Sometimes the people who are not used to comment or criticize, they find it a little difficult, but in Toastmasters, giving feedback is a part of the journey. You will listen to a speech from any other speaker, probably that person will be giving either project 1 or project 2 speech. There is no hard and fast rule as such, but it is recommended that they are at that kind of level. And then when you give that evaluation, you will know what difficulties come as a part of giving evaluation and what are the points where you have to improve your style of communicating. Like the things that I have learned personally within Toastmasters is that people have told me that at times I am rude. Although I never believed so, but people told me that, okay, although you are just speaking like facts, you are just putting the truth forward, but the way can be changed. So this third part of Project 2 is not helping me with Toastmasters much, but it is helping me with all the aspects of my life, at home, with the family, with friends, even at office, when I'm interacting with my manager and I'm pointing out some mistakes. But instead of mistakes, now this is constructive feedback. This is where Toastmasters will now train you. The third project is to move you a little forward, and you have to give another speech where you have to find some facts related to the topic you have chosen and then give a speech accordingly. This was also a part of traditional framework. The things are very much similar, but they are presented in a slightly different manner. Here you will pick a topic, do some research. For example, a lot of people say, okay, the topic which has not been yet discussed much in Hyderabad is Hyderabad traffic. So how can you research about it? You have to go online, you have to find government websites, find out how much traffic is there, how many cars are there, how many buses are there. What difference will it make if we all decide to go through public transport instead of our personal vehicles? How much pollution it generates? How much traffic violations are there? How much accidents are there? This is the kind of research that should be there behind every speech you give. At least research backed by real facts, this is what builds trust in the audience. Once you are done with these three projects, you can move on to completion where you get a certificate from your VBA and Toastmasters. Here, one very interesting part is for all the people who are just starting out, I confirm that there is no such rule that you have to do project two items in order. You have to give first speech. After that, you can either evaluate or give another speech. First point that you have to remember. And the second aspect that you have to remember is that even the speech has not to be same in project 2. It can be different, evaluator can be different, but if evaluator is different, then make sure that you forward your previous evaluation to the next evaluator. So what to do after the project here? I'll quickly summarize a few very interesting parts of Basecamp app, which is a part of Toastmaster's website. You log in, you go to the Basecamp. Before getting into that, how many of you have already seen Basecamp? You have logged in once? Okay, I hope most of them. All the new members, most of the older members. I'll strictly recommend logging to Basecamp. There will be a lot of new features that you might not be aware of. One thing is that when you complete your project, you can obtain your evaluation, get it scanned, and within Basecamp app, there is a component where you have personal documents kind of a folder. It is divided into five different levels of your path. Upload your evaluation to that folder so that your VP and you can keep a track of your progress instead of keeping taking those hard copies around. Move ahead. Okay, this might not be very much visible. Those of you who have already started looking at their pathways, have you seen this before? This is a part of your detailed curriculum. There are total of 20 projects that you have to do as a part of this. And once you do, you become a master, around 20. It might be a little up or down based on the path, but once you finish them, that means finish the level 5, you will be an expert and you will get a certificate that you have completed this part. So there will be a lot of places where you'll have, it's not clear here, but there are so many electives and you have to pick only 2 out of them. There will be a lot of such options. For this, you will discuss with your mentor, with your VP head, and find out what will be the best one for you. Move ahead. Now, all the members, please look at this slide. There is something called as awarding batches and giving feedback in Basecamp app. So what you have to do is go to Basecamp, log in, and on the top right, you can see your picture. Okay, most of you won't have any picture uploaded there, but it's better if you upload your picture in the profile so that there is a little bit of personal connection. There you can search for a Toastmaster in your club. When you go to their website, there you have a lot of different options. So for example, I have opened DTM Alfred's profile here. Here there is a section called feedback where I can click and I can give him feedback about his performance in the meetings which I've seen or his guidance he has provided to me so far or any other kind of feedback. You can search for me, those who are Toastmasters in our club, you can search for me and you can give me feedback on today's speech. Next one. So this is where you give the feedback. Meanwhile, you can also request for feedback. So my mentor or somebody else I believe should give me feedback about my speech today. I can request them personally and ask them to give me feedback about something. I can mention what was. And another very interesting part here is batches. Those of you who are software engineers, you must have seen Stack Overflow, right? How many of you have worked with, if you are a software engineer, you must have, right? How do people get active? Why do people answer your questions on Stack Overflow? This is where gamification comes in. So in pathways in Basecamp app, there is a section where you can go to my profile, you can give me one of these few batches. If you give a speech or if you help me with something or I am impressed by something else you have done for the club or for any other member in the club, I can give you badges like collaborative, you are courageous, you are exceptional, or there are plenty of other badges like this. And this is something which will motivate all your friends around in the club. So make sure you go home, log into this app, and then start giving badges to your friends in the club. Next one. Again, I've already talked about it. Next one. Okay, can you go back to the previous one? So if you have any questions right now, I can answer related to level 1 especially. Nothing yet. Those of you who are members, they can talk to VP. Yeah.
I have a question. So what happens when you complete all these 25 levels in
the okay, so first of all, you get a certificate. Like before, in our older program, once you finish the 10 projects, you get competent communicator title. So like we address each other as Toastmaster Alfred, Toastmaster Ayush. There people will be referring you as Toastmaster Ayush, comma, competent communicator. Just like we have academic awards like comma PhD. Here, you will be proficient in the path. So I do not exactly remember what the title looked like, but it will be something like proficient in this path.
So, but I mean, is there more education after this?
Yes, exactly. There is more education after competent communicator. I think you have attended meetings enough to understand it.
No, in this pathway.
Yes, exactly. How traditional program work was, you finish 10 projects from competent communicator, competent leader, and then you move forward to advanced silver, bronze kind of projects. Then they, you get more and more complicated and more precise projects. Here, it's a little different. You can pick another path after you have done with one path. So, and once you finish two different paths, that is when you become a DTM. Any other questions? Okay, if you are confused about anything, first of all, reach out to VP Ed in the club, reach out to me or any other person who has been doing pathways already. Reach out to other people in the district who are responsible for helping with pathways facilitation within the club. Along with that, there are two very interesting Facebook groups. First one is Pathways Discussion Forum. You can just search on Facebook. There is a group. Join it. And you can ask your questions. And there, every day there are at least 20 to 30 questions about people getting stuck on the UI, not being able to find something. There are several issues with the UI. I can help you work around or find a solution if you are stuck with something. Meanwhile, you can also get help from people who have been in the Pathways program for 2-3 years in other countries. Other one is Elan Toastmasters Hyderabad group. If you are a part of the group, you can ask questions about how to go ahead with your project. You can ask questions about pathways. So any other questions right now? If you have anything, you can come to me later. And let's go ahead. And all the best for those of you who are getting into pathways. If you have any questions, you can come to me anytime. I can find answers if I don't have. Thank you.
Thank you, Toastmaster Aditya. I really like the feedback section of Pathways program, where I can ask for feedback and I can give feedback online, which is something not there in the previous program. All right, now we move to the third topic for the training session today. Now, in the beginning, as Toastmaster Alfred said, that once you come to a meeting, you have to perform different roles. So a lot of people are not aware how to perform those roles effectively. So we will be picking two roles right now. The roles of Grammarian and the roles of Ah-Counter. So for that we have a Toastmaster who will be talking to us about how to perform those roles effectively. But this Toastmaster, she joined Toastmaster Club around 3 years back, and she's an Advanced Communicator Bronze and Advanced Leader Bronze. So these are two, you know, distinguished titles that you get after completing certain projects. So please join me in welcoming Advanced Communicator Bronze and Advanced Leader Bronze Toastmaster in the room.
Saturday afternoon, if you are not here and if you are at home and if it's cloudy, you must be sleeping. And out of all the educational sessions happening today, they have given me the best and most challenging section of the day, where I am sure after two educational sessions, it would be overwhelming. If I was in your place, it would have been overwhelming. So quickly, in 10 seconds, let's shift the places. Go and sit next to somebody else, somebody you don't know and you never met before. Right now, 10 seconds. Shift all of you also. Get up. I'm giving you 10 seconds. And in 10 seconds, you can seated. Yeah. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3. I'll check. How many of you have attended Toastmaster, the regular format of Toastmaster meetings before? How many haven't? Okay. For the benefit of those who raised your hands second, a Toastmasters meeting has three segments. The first is a prepared speech segment, the second is a table topic segment, and the third is the evaluation segment. The first segment has prepared speeches. So we all prepare our speeches and come and give us speeches here, which will be evaluated by a speech evaluator. The second session is the table topic session, in which specially guests non-Toastmasters can participate, because prepared speeches is usually restricted to the members of a club. Here you give impromptu speeches, which is you'll be given a topic on the spot. You have to think for a few seconds and talk what comes to your mind. The third session, I feel, is the most important part of a Toastmaster session. We come here for learning, and that learning essentially happens in the evaluation segment of a meeting. This session is conducted by somebody called a general evaluator. So the meeting hero is the Toastmaster of the day. The other person, other protagonist, is the general evaluator. These two people are equally important in conducting the meeting together. The general evaluator, before the prepared speech starts, introduces a team of people, because he or she cannot evaluate the whole meeting alone. So in their team, we'll have the speech evaluators and also a team called the TAG team. Have the Toastmasters here heard of that word TAG? So TAG is Timer, Ah-Counter and Grammarian. Apart from this, we have the Vote Counter and Sergeant at Arms also. The listener role, which is there in some of the clubs in Hyderabad, is an optional role, and we do not have it as a part of the Toastmasters International. I am here to talk about two of those roles, the Grammarian and the Ah-Counter. So the general evaluator introduces his team before the prepared speeches, and after that we'll have the prepared speeches, table topics and the evaluation session. In the evaluation session, we start off with the speech evaluators evaluating the prepared speeches. This is after table topics. After that, we'll have these three people coming in to give their reports: the timer, the Ah-Counter and the grammarian. I'm starting off with the grammarian. This role has two segments to it. It's called Wordmaster Grammarian. So the Wordmaster Grammarian has two things to do. The first thing is to come up with a word of the day and idiom of the day. So if this was a normal meeting, the grammarian would have come and given a word of the day and idiom of the day to you and said, you have to use this word and idiom as much as possible, if you can, when you speak here. So that would be the first segment. The second thing that the grammarian does is to note down all the good usages, like a good quote or a good word, a very nice way of using English language. They also note down what are all the incorrect or not so good usages that the people have used here. Can we go to the next one? So this is typically how we have a word of the day and an idiom of the day. I've taken an example. In some clubs, they have only the word of the day. In some clubs, they have both word of the day and idiom of the day. The grammarian should give the meaning very clearly and also sentences, examples to use. So just like if I tell you elate, today's word is elate, and then I say to make happy, excited or proud, you might be wondering how to use this word if you're hearing it for the first time. Elated, or is elate a word? You don't know how to use it. So then you quickly start put Google search and start seeing, and then you're not listening to the meeting. So to avoid all that, you have to give examples. So elate means to make happy, excited or proud. And then I give you two sentences. Margaret was elated when she received a bouquet of flowers. He was elated at the prospect of a holiday. Once you know that it's elated is what you have to use, then you'll come and say, I'm so elated to be a part of this meeting. So that is how a word is used. So it's very important that the grammarian gives examples as to how to use the word of the day. The other thing is the idiom. Here I've given it as blessing in disguise. An unfortunate event or situation that results in an unforeseen positive outcome. The rainstorm was a blessing in disguise that stopped the fire. Losing that match was a blessing in disguise. We would not have realized our weakness if we had won. Something like that, in a meeting you can use it if possible. I agree that blessing in disguise would have been difficult to use, but elate is something that is... So when you select a word and idiom of the day, make sure that they can be used. Can you go to the previous slide, Ayush? When I was a part of the Novartis club, one grammarian gave the word Epicurean as the word of the day. And he said Epicurean is indulging in gourmet food. Different cuisines of the world. So how can I use that word, Epicurean, in my meeting? It's very difficult to come up with something. So make something easy that a person can relate to, at the same time not so common. Something uncommon that can be easily used and is very relevant. So the introduction of the grammarian is when the general evaluator calls. Introduction starts with the grammarian coming and introducing themselves. as to what they're going to do. So they will tell everybody that they're giving a word of the day and a game of the day. That falls as their first segment of their duty, which is the word master. The second duty they have is the grammarian role, where they know down good usage and not so good usage. Depending on the club, if a person uses a word of the day, we show a single thumbs up. And they use the word and the idiom of the day, we show double thumbs up. In some clubs, for the word of the day, they use the single thumbs up. And the idiom of the day, double thumbs up. As in, if I use the word elate, I say I'm elated, then you show me thumbs up when I use it. The same way, if I use a blessing in disguise, then you show double thumbs up when I use it. So that way, the audience is encouraging the person here to use the word and the idiom of the day. What is a duty? So every role player has a preparation part. Now, many times I've seen in new clubs where people tell me, I do not want to take the grammarian role because I'm not good with my grammar. I'm not good with my grammar either. We are all not native English speakers. We are all non-native English speakers. English is a foreign language to us. So nobody is good as a grammarian. But what we're doing is learning here. So prepare yourself. Just see what you're supposed to do. You have to write down all this, that I have to note down the word of the day, how many people use word of the day, how many people use the idiom of the day. I have to note down the good usages and the incorrect usages. So you have to do it for every speaker. The role players here, the tag team, has to note down timings or whatever they're doing for everybody, starting from the sergeant at arms to the sergeant at arms. It's not only restricted to the prepared speakers and the table topic speakers. So they note down the incorrect and good usage and the word of the day and idiom of the day for all the speakers. And in some clubs, we have a board where it is written for people to, you know, visually see it and then use it. In some clubs, we stick A4 sheets. It's up to you how you want to do, depending on your club. The report is only for 3 minutes. So I put the word choose in the bracket because there'll be so much of good usages sometimes, or so much of incorrect usages. We cannot present everything here. So we have to cherry pick. We have to see what is most relevant for the audience and give that. That doesn't mean that we leave the rest of the report and take it back home. The essence of Toastmasters is giving feedback. So it doesn't mean that you give it on stage and you're just acting your role. Offline feedback is very important. So if you have a part of the report that couldn't be covered in that 3 minutes you're given, please go back and tell that person that this is the feedback. Because you're helping others. In your learning, you're also helping others to learn. So it's very important that you have something called an offline report for whatever role you take. So the report will have the names for, so when you use, when you tell somebody that they have used a good, so Aditya used hard and fast rule. So I will tell in my report that Aditya used this phrase hard and fast. But if I made a mistake, I wouldn't want somebody to point out saying I used a wrong tense or I made a grammatical mistake. So when you talk about good usages, mention the person who did it, praise them. But when you're talking about incorrect usage, just tell the correctness of, I mean, correction that is required and not the person who did it. The person here sitting knows that they did it and the others also know. But we don't have to pronounce and tell that they have done it. And we also have to give the word of the day and idiom of the day count. Like I told you, offline reports are important. So what do you learn as a grammarian? Apart from teaching the other people, what do you learn as a grammarian? We learn to listen. There is critical thinking. We give feedback, of course. And the time management, which I am severely lacking now, is something that we learn because the grammarian has only 3 minutes to introduce a role and 3 minutes to give the report. So you really need to have that timing and assimilate, make your report summarize and give it in a crisp manner. The innovation is something that we will take offline because I have a green flag here and another role to cover. This is a format that I use where you have the speaker, number of words of the day, idiom of the day, good usages and incorrect usages. Ah-Counter. So Ah-Counter, again, this person again comes in the beginning when the general evaluator introduces them, and then they come back again after the table topic session in the evaluation session to give their report. Here, the main thing that the Ah-Counter is done, Ah, as the word says, is Ah is a filler. So we have to count the number of filler words, filler sounds, double clutches and pauses used by a person. Now I can give a speech and say, my father passed away, and then I pause. And that is not something that we count as a filler word because that pause was given intentionally. When we give an unintentional pause or we've forgotten something and then pause, that is something that is counted as a filler. This person again prepares us to what they have to, the preparation essentially means that you get mentored on your role, and then you have a format, how you want to do it. Name, I'll show you the format next. And then you have to do it for every speaker. The report, the Ah-Counter is given only 2 minutes, and as the name suggests, counter, which means you just count. You do not go and make sentences and explain. You can do that offline. So in order to cover the Ah-Counter report for all the people who have spoken here, it's best you stick to these statistics. And for example, filler sounds can be and then filler words can be but, so, you know, I mean. What do you mean by double clutches is like, you know, when you use it together, it becomes. The most commonly used filler word is so. The most common filler word sound is ah. But if somebody uses but, like now I use but, it can't be a filler. Because I use but intentionally with a meaning. So the context is important. Just don't go and count the number of buts, number of so's, and that can't happen. If the so is used just like a filler, because they have forgotten what to say or they're taking time, that is when you count it as a filler word. What learning you get as an Ah-Counter is that you learn to listen. It's very difficult if you get involved in a speech to actually count the number of ahs or buts or whatever the person is saying, because you get into the speech and you forget what you do. So you learn to listen, and you also become self-aware. When somebody stands here and then keeps on using ah or her, I think about how the speech is, and I think that I shouldn't be using it. You become self-aware of your own filler words. So if I have spoken, my report would look like this. 9 ahs, 5 ahs, 2 ums, 2 buts, 3 sos, 4 you knows. If I said it, it's double clutch. And then if I pause because I don't know what to say next for quite some time, then it would be a single pause. So to be a role player, whether it's a grammarian or Ah-Counter, preparation is important, mentoring. If you go by the traditional path, you would have to choose a project, but right now in Pathways, it's not like that. We'll go to the specifications offline. Check the agenda, find somebody to evaluate you, whether it's required or not. I'm doing this role, somebody here needs to be evaluating me. That's how I get a feedback. Make sure you have the stationery, pen and paper, whatever. Have a format for reporting, and definitely take feedback after the meeting. Go and ask people how it went. You don't want to hear only good, good, good. You want to know what you have to improve on. Lastly. So I think the key determinants is that you get mentored. Even if you've done the role 10 times, 100 times, get mentored the day before you do the report, because that reinforces. It's like brushing up your basics. Prepare well. Be committed to the role, because you're not doing the role only for yourself. There is a speaker who's waiting to hear your report. So keep that commitment in mind and collaborate with the others, the GE, the time, or whoever it is, to make sure you don't go off time like me. If there are any questions, I would like to take it offline, and I would like to hand it over to the facilitator, Toastmaster Club.
Thank you, Toastmaster Club. Now, my personal experience, like roles like Grammarian and Ah-Counter, helps you build your confidence. As a new Toastmaster member to any club, I would encourage you to take these kind of roles, Ah-Counter, timer, remote counter, Grammarian. So these are like 2 minutes short, but it helps you to come here, speak, and build your confidence. That's what I started. When I started my Toastmaster journey, I started with these kind of roles. So that helped me build my confidence, and then sooner, when you build confidence, then you can take up more, meet your role. Okay, now, so there's a change in the agenda now. As per the agenda, we were supposed to have 2 more training sessions. One was on vote counter and timer, and second was on sergeant and arms. But to break the monotony, now we want to move to the table topics. So after the table topics get over, then we'll move back to table training session, because there's some kind of monotony is happening. We are having a lot of sessions right now. Just to make this meeting more fun and exciting, we'll move to the table topics.